Hey y'all, it's Stephen Van Kampen-Lewis on the morning of June 11th. It's a Sunday morning. Everybody's still kind of sleeping, or at least hanging outside. And I decided to come out and film a quick episode. I actually started this yesterday and then realized that I was just dripping sweat because we're approaching the 100 degree days here in Texas, so it's getting hot already. I want to talk to you a little bit about how quickly catasetums and cycnoches can fatten up their bulbs as they exit the dry season and go into the growing season where they're just getting water all the time. Your catasetums and cycnoches and that whole group really shouldn't dry out. Their roots should not dry out during the growing season. And I'm going to show you two examples of plants that I have actually, let's see, you see this under this little sort of lean-to tarp, that's where I'm keeping the catasetums that are still dormant. So there's like a glass panel, a plexiglass panel, and then the shade cloth so that when it rains, those plants are not getting wet, but they're still getting the ambient sunlight and whatnot. And I hadn't checked it in a couple weeks, and I had some really, really desiccated plants that were probably on the verge of dying. But it was also time for them to receive water. And what I want to show you today is how quickly those bulbs fattened up. In fact, the cycnoches fattened up within 24 hours. It was absolutely really cool. So I'll get the camera turned around and I'll show you what the plants look like now, which is a week after I noticed that I had forgotten about these plants. And then show you a couple of photos over a couple of days and to show you how the cycnoches really fattened up really quickly. But the catasetum was a little slower, which surprised me. I've seen some catasetums fatten up just as quickly as the cycnoches. But let's do a quick photo comparison and then look at the plants. So real quick, we have cycnoches versus vixii, as you can see in the tag in the background there. And you can see that this existing bulb is all nice and fat. The back bulb is nice and fat. And you can see, you know, as sort of a marker, you can see that the zip tie here is fully occupied by the cycnoches bulb, right? And then this is the catasetum. This is Catasetum gnomus, is one that I got from as an import from South America some years ago. And you can see that I actually had to up pot this one. And so what I did is I pulled this out of the pot and just tossed it in this new pot. The reason was not that it had outgrown the previous one, but the holes on the side of the pot had, it was an older pot and they had sort of rotted out, so I couldn't hang it. And it's really important for me to hang these guys. So I just had to throw it in a larger pot. This is just a milk jug, as you can see, nothing fancy. and so I didn't disturb the roots at all. I just simply put it on here and backfilled with some bark that I had lying around. Normally I like the sort of cheap cypress or hardwood mulch that I can get at a big box store, but I've got Orchiata right now and none of the other stuff. In fact, I probably should add a little bit more Orchiata. It seems to have settled. But you can see the back bulbs of this one are average. You know, they're fattening. They're not fat, but they're not skinny. They're sort of in between. These were super, super desiccated when I found them last week. So I'm just going to put these down, and then I'll just run through the pictures, and you guys can see the sort of side-by-side comparisons of what the plants originally looked like compared to now, and then I'll have the date of when each photo was taken. So let's start off with the catasetum. So you can see that a week ago, this one was just super shriveled. These back bulbs were almost gone, and they really were, like I said, pretty close to dying. The cycnoches that I'll show you in a sec was even more extreme. But and so you can see over the course of a couple days, so I started hitting it with water right away, and I immediately got the fertilizer water and the I'm also adding some of the purely organic in little baskets on the side this year, so I'm doing both. But you can see that This was super shriveled, and then it just started bouncing back really quickly over these couple of days. I'm the kind of person who just pours on the water. I have no interest in sort of getting them wet for a little while and then trying to replicate this wet-dry cycle initially. I don't see a need for that. Also, I grow using the PET method, so there's a water well on the bottom, so it kind of defeats the purpose. Once you start watering, just pour the water on, all the fertilizer that it needs, all the water, just hit it hard, and then keep that up throughout the whole growing season. And so you can see that the bulbs here are getting slowly fatter and bigger, and like I said, I've actually seen Catasetums grow their back bulbs after dormancy quite a bit more quickly than this one. But hey, you know, I'll take this. This is great. The next one I want to show you is the more extreme one. So this was the Catasetum varsovixii. You can really see how skinny the back bulb was by looking at that zip tie and seeing how much space there is between the zip tie and the bulb. So, you know, the bulb occupied maybe half the space or maybe even less. And then after 24 hours, you can see that back bulb had really, really swelled quite a bit. And then over the next couple of days, it just continues to swell. And then now that back bulb is completely occupying the entire space of that zip tie. So you can see that, you know, this one went from almost nothing to very large fat back bulbs. And this is a young plant, so it was really close to dying. You know, I like to give my plants some harsh conditions every now and then just to see what they can do, but this is too much. This was accidental. I would never have let these plants get this desiccated normally. But again, it just shows you how quickly that new root system can really slurp up the new water and nutrients. And I really encourage you guys to just hit it hard and add water and fertilizer full bore. But that's the video I wanted to show you today. And it just shows you how these plants really truly are adapted for extended dormancy with very harsh wet dry cycles between the growing and the dormant season. Not necessarily on a day-to-day basis during the growing season. They should be permanently wet that whole growing season, and then dry really only during the off season, the dormant season. But I hope you all are having a great weekend, and I will see you later. Bye.